Toronto, and some of the earlier starters are now coming in after battling a tough hilly course on a tough snowy day. The Norwegian Inger Helena Nybråten is coming in smoothly in what will apparently be the fastest time so far. Inger has improved her World Cup standing gradually from 13th to 7th over the past 3 years, and she comes in, yes, she's sitting in first place. Her time to beat now, 17 minutes, 28.2 seconds. A few Finnish supporters wait impatiently, waving their blue and white flags, with hopes that their magnificent Hämäläinen will bring the gold home once again. Here's an American, Lynn Galana, striding into the finish area now. Lynn had a fantastic first half of her race and was just about a minute off the winning time so far. She's got to feel great about that. You know, this type of gutsy endurance racing is prepared for by months of continuous aerobic training. I put together a quick education in aerobics for you earlier.
You know, aerobics is a term that's being bantered about in a sloppy and mostly incorrect way these days. Aerobic simply means with oxygen, and the aerobic activities make the heart and lungs provide continuous oxygen to the performing muscles. When doing an aerobic activity like swimming or running, the muscles send out an urgent demand for oxygen. The heart must force large volumes of blood through the blood vessels to those muscles. This makes the heart so strong and efficient that when not exercising, it has a much easier time than an untrained heart. Also, this forceful pumping helps flush the arteries clear of the buildup from fat and cholesterol. This is the reason that aerobics produce good health. Most studies agree that cross-country skiers are superior aerobically to all other athletes. Swimmers demand oxygen, but mainly from the upper body. Runners and cyclists, mainly from the lower body. Rowers are relieved somewhat from working against gravity by sitting and sliding horizontally. Now let's look at the cross-country skier. The legs are virtually running full out throughout a race. The back, shoulders, and arms are executing forceful contractions on every step. The abdomen is under constant strain, especially when bobbing during double poling. So we realize two things from this information. One, the Olympic cross-country skiers whom you are seeing are by far the fittest athletes aerobically in the world. And two, a novice like you or me can get on the trails and in a very short time get a great workout for our hearts. This is only my seventh time on cross-country skis, and within 10 minutes of hard work from leaving this spot, I will produce a full sweat, my muscles will demand that oxygen, and I will receive the cardiovascular benefits with every stride.
Back at the finish line action of the 5K, here is the top woman of the Swedish team, Mari Risby.
Oh, she's having a great race. You know, she's never had a top 10 finish in any Olympic competition. She skied in 76 and 80, and she's just keeping going strong. She went out hard and long stride coming into the finish. She can really be proud of this one. And you can see she's even got the lead right now.
Well, as we watch the running clock, she's very close to Nybråten's leading time of 17:28.2 there at the top of the screen. And yes, 2 seconds faster, Risby takes the lead with 17:26.3. Risby was the number 38. We expected to see the Soviet skier next, Metanina. But here it is, Hämäläinen, unmistakable in her towering form, even from a distance. And you can hear the Finns yelling themselves hoarse through the blustering wind.
Diana, she's really skiing well. Her coaches are out on the course. They've got radios. They're letting her know how she's doing in this race, but she's got to keep pushing. She's got to go hard all the way to the finish. She knows she's good. There's her time. She's ahead of Risby right now. It's going to be a question of how many seconds.
We are seeing a potential gold medal. Maria Lisa skiing her way into the history books here right in front of us.
Oh, that's better than 20 seconds over Risby, Diana. She really punched in a hard one, and the only people that I think can catch her are probably Aunli and Yaryova. They're still out on the course, but she's got to be happy because they're going to really have to get it on to get in here.
Look at this. There's pain after a draining race like that, but I guarantee if she gets the gold, there'll be much elation.
You know, Diana, you talked about the endurance aspects of cross country earlier in the show, but you know, Maria is really a good example of the power that comes in with every step and every pole plant. She goes further and faster down that track than anybody else.
Kvetta Yaryova now skis into our picture. Yaryova has a reputation for inconsistent skiing, but the upswing of that pattern is that she seems to put it all together when it really counts. She was the bronze medalist in this 5K distance at Lake Placid and seems to be coming in with another potential medal performance this time around. Her running time will not allow her to get in as fast as Hämäläinen, but Jack, she looks like she's going to eclipse Risby's second place.
You could see her pick it up in the last 100 yards here. She is really cooking. She's already a little bit out. but she's going to be ahead of Risby. Yes, she's ahead of Risby. She's in second place right now. Annalee's the only one left, Diana.
17:18.3. She eclipsed Risby by some 7 seconds, now sitting with the silver medal, and as you say, the only one out there who could beat it is Berit Almley. Marja-Liisa Hämäläinen, becoming a familiar face to us Americans at this point, surrounded by her compatriots. And now, the last possible medalist hits the final stretch, Norway's Berit Almley. It's nearly impossible to successfully compete again at a world-class level after a year away from a conditioning sport, much less a year away having a baby. Almley has skied a tremendous race, and the clock indicates a possible silver medal, and she's got it, 17:14.1, the silver medal. That's got to be the comeback of the year in this sport, Jack.
I think that's just great. There's a lot of pressure on her to even make this team, and she should really be proud of herself.
Well, the Finns around here have lost all restraint in rejoicing over their heroine's heroics. Hämäläinen takes the gold, Berit Almley of Norway takes the silver, and Kvita Yerryova of Czechoslovakia repeats her bronze performance of 80. And American Lynn Galanis puts in her best race of the season to finish 27th. But the big story today, Marja-Liisa Hämäläinen. First, she wins the first gold of the games, and now she becomes the first person to win two gold medals at the 14th Winter Olympic Games here in Sarajevo.
Really?